Hello everybody, my name is Gradimo, and welcome back to Let's Play Batman, a Telltale Game series. Now, we left off in the last episode. It was Bruce Wayne was going to Cobblepot Park to investigate the mysterious reappearance of Oswald Cobblepot. I ended up having to leave it there because I was already 40 minutes into recording that long-ass beginning. So, here we go. We're gonna take a look, see what's going on. Welcome back to Cobblepot Park, 6:06 a.m. Okay. So I like how he's just down here, still wearing, like, fancy pants, nice shoes, nice shirt. You know, like, this place kind of seems like a scuzzball-y place. You'd think he'd more be wanting to wear something like jeans and a t-shirt, or just some things we wouldn't quite stand out as a prestigious businessman, at least. Hey, that's about the thing that I, did with, Carmine Falcone. Oh, shit. Okay. I actually meant to go and select that other thing. Okay. Oh, no, I didn't want to go down the stairs. God damn it. Okay. Graffiti. There we go. I can look at the graffiti. Okay, that's it. Okay, so I have to say, I'm curious to know if any of Batman's primary villains have come into the woodworks yet. Like, yes, we now know of the appearance of Penguin and Catwoman, but I want to know, like, has the Joker made an appearance? What about Scarecrow? You know, anybody? That's it? I'm just gonna look at... Oh, okay. Here you go, fella.
Thank you, sir.
Go get yourself a bottle of booze or some drugs or whatever it is you're into. Let's look at the burning barrel. What could be so mysterious about the burning barrel? Oh, apparently I'm just cold. Oh, okay. Fine. That's cool. So, I got a feeling, like, there's gonna be something about poison ivy. Just, I don't know why. Perhaps, maybe the overgrown vegetation. What the fuck was that? Oh, that was my cell phone. Running late, meet you by the statue.
Great.
Well, I'm running a little bit late technically,
statue,
too.
But no odds.
Seeing as how we did say 6 a.m. and we walked up here at 6:06 a.m. So... Okay, let's see. Let's look at the shopping cart. What could be mysterious about a shopping cart? Oh, there's another shopping cart. It's a shopping cart extravaganza! Can I go up these stairs? No. Do I want to look at you, smoking man?
Hey.
Beat it!
Well, that wasn't very nice. Okay, so I don't want to go to the statue yet, because I don't want to key next scene or anything. I want to keep looking around. Okay. Plaque.
Well, that isn't what it used to be.
Okay, I couldn't really even get a look at that. Graffiti! More graffiti! Okay, so I guess there's supposed to be Easter eggs in this graffiti, but I'm not actually noticing anything. Although the graffiti by the entrance with the red spray paint did kind of give me, like, vibes of anarchy. Oh, shit, I did not mean to do that. Okay, back down we go. Okay, so I'm guessing we've looked at everything down here, so now to the statue.
Watch wallet cash. But this goes through you.
Oh, I'm so scared.
Hey, you heard it, man. The hell are you waiting for?
You're making a mistake.
You already made one coming here. The next one kills you.
End him.
Gentlemen.
Oz.
Keep walking, all right?
This don't concern you, twerp.
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do.
And you're the moment!
Whoa.
Come here. Think that'll do?
Oh, shit. Oz isn't the fucking pussy in this. Oh, shit. I was hitting A because for a second I thought I was on my PS4 controller. Oh, shit. This guy's got a gun. Oh.
This used to be a nice place. No lives like you don't belong.
Oh, shit. Whoa.
This is my park. Mine. You hear that?
Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, Yeah, good as new.
But nothing on his shirt.
Woo! That was the right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh?
Well, thanks for the backup.
I yanked you away from your bloody ivory tower, Bruce. Least I can do is make sure you don't get shanked.
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you.
Yeah, it's been what? 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
Well, those were better days.
That they were, yeah. Thought we'd grow up to be kings, I did. Both of us. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it himself, he did. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round-the-world vacations, unlimited potential.
I'm sorry, Oz. No one should have to go through that.
Thanks, Bruce. But we are not the only ones suffering. Good to know you haven't changed, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home. That oily...
Falcone was an uninvited guest. That's it. I never want to see his face again.
On that, we can agree in earnest. Falcone made a stack of cash and corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement.
Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, no? A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my our revolution starts. We're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
I'm not your enemy, Oz.
That remains to be seen, don't it?
I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you.
When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers.
Okay, so just gonna throw this out there. I'm pretty sure Oswald Cobblepot grew up in Gotham. The same as his parents grew up in Gotham and his parents' parents grew up in Gotham. Like, Cobblepot was an old and storied family. And yet he's got a British accent. Wow. Bruce Wayne has nice ride.
Mr. Wayne, over here. Right here.
This way.
Bruce, Bruce!
Good morning, everyone. Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars?
I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. We didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. Worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. And Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
For those with mental health issues, there are no cuts or scrapes. Their ailments are often invisible, but inside, they're suffering. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. My parents were heroes that night, and we can all learn from their sacrifice.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
I think Arkham has only done harm to Gotham. It's made criminals more unstable, put our citizens in jeopardy. We can do better. All right, who's up next? You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remark of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You and Mr. Dent even spoke with him behind closed doors.
I don't make friends with gangsters. He was an unwelcome guest. That's all. Next question, please.
Please, keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
And did anyone else receive this evidence?
The Globe, the Gazette, we all did. Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What aren't you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
All right, this press conference is over.
Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What aren't you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. I don't know where the hell it's coming from. Damage control's my territory. We'll talk later.
Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Okay, and we'll have to pause it right there. Okay, let's get back to it.
Hey, careful! Put it back.
I'm afraid we can't, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
I understand. You're just doing your job, Lieutenant.
Trying to. It's hard to be a cop in this city. Every battle's uphill, in the rain, with skates on.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
And what do you expect to find?
That's for our analysts back at the precinct to figure out. I can't comment. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Well, Hill has a history of making his opposition disappear.
Rumors and allegations, Mr. Wayne, that's all. But if they become fact, I'll handcuff him myself, same as any other crook. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's shopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Wow, what an asshole.
Bruce, stay back.
Take whatever you want.
You don't have to do this.
Bruce? I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
Hello, Miss Vale.
It's not a problem, really.
Ah, Bruce. First the mayor's office, now Wayne Manor. Gotham continues its streak of break-ins.
Yeah, really going for the record, huh?
Listen, Bruce. A scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this.
What's your angle?
Not all reporters just want a headline. Some of us are old-fashioned. I still want the truth. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family. After me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran.
Carmine Falcone wants me to be in his pocket. He crashed Harvey's fundraiser and pretty much said, hop in.
Well, maybe he thinks putting a little fear in you will make you jump.
It won't.
By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
On the record, then.
Whenever you're ready.
The Wayne family has always been a cornerstone of Gotham. We have never had and never will have connections to organized crime.
That's exactly what the people of Gotham need to hear. You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Vale.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family... We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this on the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
A warrant? What the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning?
Yeah, someone's coming after me.
Let's avoid making another scene, shall we? The press is already up my ass as it is. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah, then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this, I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it.
Okay, I believe you, Harvey. Mayor Hill's trying to screw us both over with this move.
And then he's made two enemies. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? That just doesn't make sense. I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
That is exactly what I intend to find out.
Easy, Bruce. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. And that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign.
Then I'll go it alone. I've got plenty of resources to fight this.
We're in a bind here, Bruce. I'll do whatever I can to help.
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry. I got a habit of being late.
No, just glad you made it.
Selina Kyle. Oh,
you didn't
they
tell
know.
Me you were bringing a friend to dinner.
This is Selena.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Just election nonsense.
I'm Bruce Wayne.
So you are.
Pleasure to meet you, Miss...
Kyle. It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, she knows.
Sorry.
Selena's new to town. I've been showing her around Gotham, introducing her to people.
You're an excellent tour guide, Harv.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
So, Miss Kyle, what brings you to Gotham?
Business.
Well, let's just hope she stays after what happened last night.
I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
Did you at least get a look at the guy?
Good enough to make an ID.
I'll get Gordon down to GCPD to work on a lineup. That's probably long gone by now. Whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Ooh. Sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my client. When things like this happen in my line of work, people tend to overreact.
We should just be thankful you got away with a black eye.
I'm sure your clients will understand.
I doubt it. In my business, people aren't very forgiving. At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment. Hey, it's Harvey.
Nice to meet the real you.
Likewise.
This explains a lot, actually. How you can afford the fancy armor, the toys. Wouldn't Harvey be surprised? Not to mention, everyone in this cafe.
Sorry about the black eye.
It's not the first time a man's hit me.
Sorry to hear that.
Don't worry. I'm not gonna expose you. Yet. I'm curious about something, though. I do what I do for money, but you're... Bruce Wayne. What's your excuse? I have to. But you... Why take the risk?
I don't need one. I do this... because I can.
And I thought you were on some noble crusade against crime. Silly me. You have something that belongs to me. I want it back. This is awkward for me. I'm used to robbing people, not the one being robbed.
As I recall, you took something from me, too. Hope you're getting some use out of that grappling gun.
I'm more interested in how I can use you. These people I'm working for, they don't screw around. If I fail to deliver that drive, it's gonna cost a lot more than money.
Well, looks like you've made your bed.
No, we've made this bed, and I'm not gonna lie in it alone. You owe me. If they don't get what they want, there will be consequences. I don't like consequences.
All right, you want my help? You got it. What can I do?
You can give me back the drive.
Not possible.
Listen, I don't have a lot of time. My employer is expecting me to drop it off.
Where?
Just give it back.
The address, now.
No, give me the drive.
You're just going to have to trust me.
I don't do trust. I guess I'm screwed either way. My contact, he'll be expecting a cat, not a bat.
When are you supposed to meet him?
15 minutes ago. Better hurry.
Everything okay here?
You tell me.
I have my people working on it. We're gonna straighten everything out.
I feel better already. Sorry, but I've got to run.
So soon? Aren't you gonna stay for a drink?
Yeah, Bruce. Stay for a drink?
I'd love to, but I've got another appointment and I really don't want to be late for it.
Oh, all right then. Don't forget to change into your suit.
Alfred, I'm at the warehouse. No sign of Catwoman's contact. It's quiet.
The sound of an ambush. Stay on guard.
Okay. Oh shit, yo, there's people dead here. Okay, what's up with the White Rose? White Rose.
This wasn't a handoff. It was a massacre.
White Rose.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Oh, good lord. Who could have done such a thing?
That's what I'm gonna find out.
Gordon, Eastside Docks, Warehouse 133.
I should know where that white rose is from. Because one of the cops right now is holding a white rose.
Analyzing. It's a volatile chemical. Potential psychoactive nerve agent. Vile stuff.
Be very, very careful with that. Who knows what effect it may have.
Have the computer catalog the compound for further analysis.
As you wish.
Nothing left to bury.
Oh, that's cool. This is like the Rocksteady ones, the like detective mode. That's really cool.
Whatever exploded did so with enough force to obliterate the person standing next to it. But the chemicals themselves were inert. Not explosive.
Well, it appears to have made a pretty big boom.
I'll see what I can piece back together.
Okay, White Rose.
White Rose. Falcone's calling.
Oh, it is Falcone. Oh,
he's been busy as of late.
Send the drones hunting. I want to know his every move.
Good thinking, sir.
All right, so Carmine Falcone had something to do with this. Now, I also think that he had Mayor Hill sign off on that GCPD warrant to get in Bruce Wayne's way. I think that's primarily what that was all about. Now, that was kind of already covered, so you guys already know that by now. Or at least that theory.
I've seen these outfits before. Same mercs that broke into City Hall.
Hey, they are. Okay, I'll open that in a minute. Pretty. Link that to that. Oh, I can link it to something else, maybe. Burnt cop. Man, that sucks.
Span's been badly burned. The damage seems to originate from inside his skull.
What did this?
Wow.
Sensors say it's an incendiary route. Phosphorus residue. This could have superheated the contents of the canister,
causing the aforementioned boom.
Blood. Broken nails. Bits of human flesh.
So, what? Was he clawing at something? Examine the dead mercenary.
Ugh.
That bad?
Face slashed. Throat torn open.
So, not natural causes then.
Skyline Club.
Okay, now I don't understand what exactly stuck out about that pocket. Bloody hands, ripped up face.
A cop shredded this merc to pieces, barehanded.
God, what would cause someone to do that?
The nerve agent could make them psychotic.
In here. Nothing on them.
Canisters were stored here. Canisters of what?
How do you know that there were canisters here? All I see are empty pallets. Shot cop.
It's a cop. The force grows thinner every day.
Scorched area. Something was there. A vehicle.
Something was here when the explosion occurred.
It's forklift, perhaps? No. Dead cop up there, dead mercenary there. Okay. So now let's examine the shipping container.
The canister exploded, sending shrapnel right through the container door.
For once, I'm glad you arrived after the heist. Your armor wouldn't have protected you against that.
All right, let's see what surprises lay behind this door. Whoa, muscles. Save that for Superman. Okay, canister fragment, and it...
Looks like a bullet started this.
A normal bullet couldn't have caused that explosion.
Doesn't appear normal. The point of entry's melted.
Is that all that's in here? Okay. I see. I had to cancel the link between the blast epicenter. Okay, and link to canister. Let's see.
Find a connection.
The bullet that killed the cop is the same type that blew up the canister.
Well, I'm sure they didn't find that at the local gun store.
It appears military.
Okay. And now I'm gonna link that to the unscorched area.
Someone drove off after the explosion.
Have you put it together?
Yes.
Oh, here we go.
Falcone leaving his rose here. This is a message. Dead cops, stolen chemicals. He's making a big move. One of his snipers hit a canister with an incendiary bullet, causing it to superheat and explode. This may have been a distraction or a way of destroying evidence. Cops moved in to stop the theft. Falcone's men gunned him down. Then things turned grim. Possibly due to the psychoactive nerve agent. A cop ripped up a merc's face with his bare hands. And was put down. Same sniper, same type of bullet. Looks like Falcone's men got what they wanted and escaped.
Have you located the shooter?
No, but based on two impact trajectories, the canister and the dead cop, the shooter could only have a clear shot from there, there, or there. And would have contaminated himself with the phosphorus residue. Program the skimmers to pick up that signature.
Right away, sir.
Okay. Okay. Bat tech to reveal trace evidence of phosphorus. Okay.
Both targets could have been shot from here, but no phosphorus trace.
We'll go here first.
Phosphorus spike. Clear vantage point. We have a winner. Killing time.
Cigarette was lit.
This is the right spot. So where did he go? Trace stops here.
Then he should be nearby.
Found him. Time to go to work. Don't make me add your corpse to this graveyard. Falcone, why did he do this?
I ain't telling you nothing! You can't make me talk! I ain't telling you, Jack!
I don't mind torturing you. So you better say something.
You trying to scare a confession out of me? I won't break!
Your bones will.
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
It's true what they said about you. You're a freaking animal.
Time to live up to my reputation. You know, you can bleed to death without ever spilling a drop. All on the inside. Tell me the plan, or I start swinging. Tell me!
The Catwoman was supposed to hand over a drive, had the container number we needed, but she flaked. So we had to find it ourselves. Container by container. Someone must have heard us. Called the cops. We were told no witnesses.
Why risk open war with the GCPD?
Some kind of chemicals. Falcone wanted them.
What are the chemicals for?
We were paid to steal them, not ask questions.
No! Stop! You can't do it!
I start here and keep breaking until you answer.
The chemicals! Some kind of explosive! A weapon! I don't know! Falcone said he'd use them soon!
Used where?
That's all I know! I swear! I swear! I told you everything I know!
You're an animal! I was just here for a pickup! I swear! You're Batman! You're supposed to be a good guy!
Oh, God.
Jesus Christ. These are cops. Get an ambulance in here.
I think I need to call the coroner instead.
He tried to kill me.
Who tried to kill you?
The Batman.
You're taking this too far, Bruce.
Well, I didn't break his arm. Like, I thought about it, like, really hard, but I didn't.
You assume the persona of a bat, but you're not an animal. You beat that man half to death. Your parents didn't raise you this way. And neither did I.
He's still alive, isn't he?
And in the hospital. Next time, it might be the morgue. Especially now, during this preposterous attack on your family. You must show the world the true nature of a Wayne.
Giving everything to the city and then being murdered for it?
My thoughts exactly. Every time you leave this cave. You're a good man, Bruce. Good. Just like your parents. Don't lose that.
I don't mean to be a doddering old fool on the subject, but as a friend, the burden of advice falls on me.
Who my parents were, the life they led, Gotham revered them. I could never match that.
You won't. You will far surpass them. You bury the person, Bruce. But you never bury the memory.
Sometimes I wish I could. That night, that alleyway, it made me who I am. I can't get it out of my head.
That is your gift and your curse. Being Batman can allow you to turn back the tide of treachery that's reached this city's shores, or drown you in its sorrow. When you doubt your fate, remember why you started all this.
There's the
boy in the alley.
I won't forget.
Neither will I. Well, back into the fray again.
Okay. Let's see. Gotham Feed. Yeah, okay, that's just some more reading. I don't feel like doing that. Codex? Okay. Turns out her real name is Selina Kyle, and she's friends with Harvey, but more troubling, she knows I'm Bruce Wayne. This will need to be dealt with soon. Yes, it will. I will have to woo her. Okay, nothing over there, nothing down here, that's it. Okay, up here we go.
Well, looks like that egg finally cracked. And inside, Mayor Hill was hiding more than I could have imagined.
Nice.
This is a complete manifest of Carmine Falcone's criminal organization.
What in the world was Hill doing with all this?
Hill was using it to
blackmail. Illegal arms dealing, drug running, mob hits, money laundering. Falcone's been involved in everything. But it goes back years.
This is an insurance policy. Hill could expose Falcone if he didn't play along.
That would explain why he's never made a move against him.
Sure as hell better than any bodyguard. This is it, Alfred. With this proof, we can finally knock out Falcone's organization.
Where would we possibly begin to dismantle it?
This is a police matter.
There's only one cop we can trust to handle this evidence correctly.
Lieutenant Gordon.
Lieutenant Gordon. He could mobilize the entire police force against Falcone.
What about that reporter from the Gazette?
Vicky.
Yes, Miss Vale. Oh. She could release this evidence through proper channels. I suppose it comes down to who you want to help most. Or who you think could do the most good.
Well, I'm going to go for Vicky Vale, because Lieutenant Gordon is at the moment still in Mayor Hill's pocket. Meaning, there is no direct evidence toward Mayor Hill that he is working with Carmine Falcone that has been mentioned, so I don't know if that actually exists. Whereas Vicky Vale, she can do what she wants without any necessary job repercussions. So I'm gonna go for Vicky Vale.
Vicky showed faith in me. She cares about the truth. She'll get the story out the way it needs to be told.
A wise decision, sir. We'll attack Falcone on two fronts tonight. Vicky through the media, and Batman
by any means necessary.
Oh yeah.
Whatever Falcone is planning, it ends tonight.
He's a spider, Bruce. Eyes everywhere. A dense web of goons poised to trap you. No one has ever managed to bring him down.
I haven't tried yet.
This is big. You drop a bomb like this, there's gonna be fallout.
That not even Falcone can survive.
Why give it to me then? You don't know how much I appreciate it, but you're Wayne. You could have given it to anyone.
I need an ally in the press.
After handing me something like this, I'd say you got one for life. Falcone's slippery, but this is enough to hang him out to dry. What this could do for the city, my career, I'm just wondering what the cost is going to be.
It'll be worth it.
I don't know, Bruce. Falcone doesn't like bad press. If I run this story, I put a price on my head. The next time my name appears in the media, God, it might be an obituary.
I'll protect you, I promise.
Oh, chivalrous, but unnecessary. You're not Batman. I always think, crime in the city, it's a hydra. You cut off one criminal's head.
Three more appear in its place, I know.
Unless we kill the beast once and for all. But who's even capable of that? If we don't act fast, that void will be filled by someone far worse. Wouldn't be the first time.
Lieutenant Gordon, he has his badge in the right place.
Yeah, well, I hope that's enough. Sometimes the rest of the force, they have their own agenda. It's a good thing you gave this to me instead of the police. Could end up buried in some evidence locker and not on every screen in Gotham where it belongs.
Public attention. That's what brings down men like Falcone. Not a bullet.
Though after my story runs, he might get that too. I'll be seeing you, Bruce.
So, a little piece of me is actually kind of regretting that now, just because now I know...
Good. So is our hunt.
It can put her in danger.
The drone's located Falcone downtown, a place called the Skyline Club. Though you're not dressed for that kind of party.
Well, I can always change in the car.
Oh, man. No way. That was so cool. So, yeah, that was awesome. That was so awesome. Oh god.
The drone's cameras and scanning tech are fully functional.
All right. Let's find Falcone.
Okay, maneuver the drone around the outside of the club to find Falcone. Okay. That's definitely not Falcone. Use left stick to maneuver the drone. Oh, okay. Look at balcony.
Good point of entry.
Tell me another.
What's the difference between the Mafia and City Council?
I don't know. Aren't they the same thing?
Only one of them is organized.
Ooh. You're cute.
Oh.
So, are you alone?
Not anymore, I thought.
That was smooth.
You make your round? Yeah, no broken bones. Still healing from the last time, I bet. All it took was a couple of C notes this time. Nice and easy. Nice and easy, my ass. I know you burned powder tonight. The whole city can smell it.
Okay. Oh, hello. What is that?
Nothing here.
Well, then why is it a point of interest? Office over there.
That's the most heavily guarded door in the building.
Gotta be Falcone's hideout.
Well, it won't be as easy as ringing the doorbell.
Four armed guards. Stealth not an option.
Oh man, that reminds me of the
attack. Stand by.
In James Bond, the world is not enough. Those glasses he has. Where you can see, like, people's knives and guns and, like, all their weapons underneath their clothes and everything. Yeah. That was a great movie. Pierce Brosnan, man. He was a fantastic James Bond. Alright. Examine the mobster.
Couple of options for taking this guy down.
Okay, here we go. Okay, you know what? I like that. That mobster. Those stairs. this mobster. Large coffee table, folding screen. Move this work of art. Can I use this work of art? Okay. Alright. Folding screen. Seated gentleman. Oh, gunman. Oh, okay, sorry. I misread that. Okay. I think that'll work. And I do believe there is one more. Yeah. He did say four, right? Right there is one. Yeah. Okay, maybe up here then? Oh, there he is.
This one might be tricky. Any ideas?
I've got it covered, Al.
Ah! The work of art. There we go. That's why it was noticeable. Am I going to throw the modern art at him? I am going to throw the modern art at him. Okay, this is going to be awesome.
Bruce, have you formulated your plan of attack?
I'm going in.
Very good, sir.
Oh, yeah.
Your turn to crash his party.
All right, here we go. Oh, yeah! Ooh. He just took modern art to the face. So let's hope my right bumper's working this time.
Goddamn circus freak!
Oh crap! Those people are dead.
Show yourself! You got no goddamn right to be here. I want Gotham and a mass.
Okay, right bumper works as right trigger for things like that. You know what? The TV. I'm going for the screens. I gotta be morally not as able to kill people.
Stay down, Falco. We can end this now.
You got a lot to learn, kid.
Oh shit! He's got a Gatling gun, yo. Come on. Oh, damn it. Alright, looks like I'm... What's going on? Okay, hold on. We are having some technical difficulties here, people. Okay. It's okay. I got this covered. I got it handled. It's okay. Okay. There we go. Resume game. There we go.
Explosions
and now I can
armed.
Go back to the control.
Fire when ready. Jeez.
Oh, that is so cool. I want a drone with a rocket on it. I don't know what I would need the rocket or the drone for, but that'd be pretty fun.
Spare yourself the pain, old man.
Yeah, I've been through worse. I'll kill you right after the hot dog.
The chemicals. Where are they?
What?
I found your calling card at the docks. The White Rose.
You think I wanted to lead you here? Yeah, something reeks about this whole thing. And it ain't a dead bat.
That hurt my nose.
Still want to play games?
We're all being played here, including you. Those chemicals you're so riled up about, they're mine, all right? But someone is trying to cut me out of the deal because I did not make that mess at the docks.
Then who did?
No, we're done. Gotham's watching now. Give him a show. I'll be walking free by tomorrow morning.
That's right. Okay. I could arrest him or I could brutalize him. Oh, shit.
Spill it, Falcone. While you still can.
It's the Waynes. They're behind all this.
What do you mean?
You want to save this city? Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
Thanks for the assist. Now we only have to take one of you down. Open fire!
Well, that wasn't very nice.
Fire and smoke could reportedly be seen from street level. Tonight, the Skyline Club, a high-rise mafia hangout in downtown Gotham, was the arena for a clash between the notorious Batman and alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone, who was found dangling over a 50-story drop. Bet Falcone loved that view. Though I'd say the crime boss getting his is well overdue, Falcone has slipped through the law's grasp for years. But after this dramatic arrest and a stunning expose by Gazette reporter Vicky Vale, Falcone's going away for a long, long time. And speaking of newly uncovered criminal dealings, this brings me to the story everyone is talking about. The Wayne family. For generations, the big W on the Wayne Enterprises Tower was a reassuring sight. you knew that there was something pure at the heart of Gotham. That this city, for all its faults, was built by good people. But with Thomas and Martha's shining reputation called into question, we no longer have such assurances. And even worse, it seems the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree. Gotham's greatest son, Bruce Wayne, seen here in the company of gangsters, may be just as crooked as his parents. In his defense, Wayne fired back, saying,
"The Wayne family has always been a cornerstone of Gotham. We've never had and never will have connections to organized crime."
In a world where the Waynes, our golden family, are corrupt, who are we left with? Who can Gothamites look up to? The supposed hero Batman? Only time will tell. Meanwhile, we'll keep digging for the truth. But the prominent feeling throughout Gotham is that the Wayne's time in the sun is ending.
Nice entrance.
The suit, the car, this entire cave.
Master Bruce?
Everything I built. I created all of this because I didn't want any more innocent people to die. If Falcone's telling the truth about my parents, then what the hell did we do this for?
Bruce, I...
What have you been hiding from me? Alfred!
All right, so that is the end of episode 1. Thank you all for watching. I am Gradimo, and I should probably go through what these choices were, shouldn't I? Okay, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to go through this before I stop this. Did you stick up for Harvey in front of Falcone? I did. And so did 68% of players. I don't need to share that choice. Okay. Did you provide a quote for Vicky's story? I did, and so did 88.9% of players. Wow. You and 48.4% of players showed mercy in your interrogation of the Doc Shooter. Wow, people wanted to see his arm break. Holy crap. Who did you give the Falcone data to? Really? Wow. Only 29%. Wow, that is actually pretty surprising. I thought that'd be like, I thought that was at least a 50-50. Had a Batman deal with Falcone at the end. Alright, so I'm happy to know that humanity, for the most part, has decided to be morally good. All right. I don't need to share all my choices. All right, everybody. So I'm going to stop the video right there as credits are rolling and we've gone through the episode statistics. I am Gradimo, and thanks for watching the Batman Telltale Games Let's Play Episode 1, Part 2. And I will see you next time. Come on. You know you want to let me kill myself. I don't know why, but this one is incredibly challenging to me. Okay, so we have... Come on, why can't I move you now? No. There we go.